Hey, what's up everyone? This is DCSG81 and in this video, I will talk about the fixes for the bicep portions of this Marvel Legends 80 years anniversary Iron Man. Okay, so for this this is sort of like the part 2 videos of the fixes. You can take a look at the part 1 video right here, which I just posted yesterday. So this time it's not about the legs, but it's about the hands, in particular the biceps area of the hand. So again, this is actually pointed out to me by my friends Alexis Lim, and also some there's another viewer of mine left a comment about these fixes that has been made by Fush. You can actually see I will actually post the link of his video later. So okay, so I'll just discuss what's the problem first. So the very first the problem is that as Push has pointed out, the arms is actually being put at the wrong side. Okay, so you can actually see there are two lines here, and there's one line on the one, just a single line at the outside, and there's a double line on the inside. So same goes for here. Okay, so what he mentioned is it's supposed to be, the two lines is supposed to be facing the outside, and the one line is supposed to be facing the inside. So these two arms, as particular for the bicep area, is being put at the wrong side. So what you need to do is you just need to pop this out, this portion, and then just switch them over. Okay, and then for the second portions of the fixes, he also mentioned some things about the arm is not aligned properly, and also the something like the hose is supposed to be on the because after you switch these arms over here, you can see the there's a bigger hose for the pack, and right now here is the smaller hose on the outside and the bigger hose on the inside. But he mentioned something about after you switch it over, so you, the bigger holes are on the outside now, and then you need to he did some adjustment. He actually popped this out, popped the packs out, and then he switched over, and there's quite a number of popping out, which really worries me, because as you know, Marvel Legends tends to, the joint tends to get loosened over time. So if you really pop things out even before you start playing with it, I believe it will get loosened even faster. So okay, so in now is I already discussed what's the problem and how's the fix, but why I'm not doing it on the screen is because to me it's really all about the single line and the double line things, which doesn't really bothers me, because to me it still looks pretty good. I mean, if I really can't tell the difference. Except for the legs is quite obvious, but this one is, you really doesn't know. So I'm going to show another Marvel Legends that I have to prove that what he say is either is correct or wrong. So as you can see, for this Colossus, there's a double line on the bicep, and then on the inside is only a single line. So what he mentioned is true, that this arm, the double line should be on the outside, not on the inside. So you really need to switch them over. But to me, why I'm not tempting to do it, because once we switch it over, as I mentioned earlier, the bigger holes here will be on the outside, and the tinier holes will be on the inside, which actually to me, it actually ruined the overall look of the figure, because right now I think it looks very good. The joint, the holes for the pegs is actually kept to the minimal, the very small one, and the ugly side is actually facing inside, so that it's not that obvious when you take photo. Same goes for the leg. You can see the leg having the smaller holes on the outside, and the bigger hole is actually on the inside. So I don't see the need to actually, you know, switch it over just because of the line, but you actually expose the uglier side of the pack holes. Yeah, so that's my thoughts. And I compare with the Colossus. It's also the same. You can see the holes, the pack holes here on the outside is smaller, but on the inside one is much bigger. Okay, so if I really switch it over, it'll be the other way around. The holes is actually much bigger on the outside. It looks very ugly, and then it also looks inconsistent with the leg. So you have big holes here and then small holes here. To me, that really bring out more disadvantage than the advantage of the two lines and one line bicep things. To me, I think it's fine as it is. So it's really up to you guys. If you guys would like to do the change just because of the one line, two line things, so I'm sorry that I can't show it to you because I don't intend to do it. But you can actually check the Fush video out. He did demonstrate how to do it in a step-by-step manner, so you can actually just follow his step. But to me, my opinion is it just doesn't worth it, you know, just to switch thing over. I think the switching for the bicep is fine, but once he gets into the fixes for his arms, he start to take things out and put things back in. That's the part that I don't really think it's a good idea to do that. Except you, unless you are a perfectionist that you like your figure to look just like the perfect kind of thing. But to me, it really doesn't matter. I mean, I rather keep the joint tight than just to switch out things and then ends up the joint start to get loosened, and even worse, if you break anything, then that's it. Okay, so that's my point. Of course, you can disagree with me. If you would like to change, then you can just go ahead and look at the Fush video. But to me, I just make this video just to tell my viewer about my point. I think it's just not necessary to do that. Okay, so because another reason is why I do this video is also I have viewers who ask me to do it, to do the switch. So I'm addressing it now in this video. So yep, sorry to disappoint that I'm not going to change it. So of course, if you guys like to do it, you can take a look at the Fush one. And I would like to say best of luck of that, because I just feel that it's not really a good idea. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you find it informative, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.